let's have a look with the new chapter known as network functions. One of the most simplest chapter, similar to what we did in lab class. When I say similar to it, I mean by the basic formula of inductor and capacitor. The only thing in type 1 we need to do it, we need to find driving point impedance. When I say driving point impedance, I mean by Z of X. So, if I need to find driving point impedance, I just need to remember two basic formulas. One is parallel, one is series. You have to combine the whole network by using a parallel and series combination to find the value of Z of X. Before that, I need to convert all the parameters into a frequency domain by using a Laplace. R, C, and L. For R, it will be as it is. C, it will be 1 upon Cs, which we have seen in Laplace. L, again, we have seen in Laplace, it is nothing but L. So, first thing, before finding driving point impedance, my dear friends, I need to convert my circuit into a Laplace. So, it will be capacitor 1 upon Cs, resistance as it is, your inductor is your L. So I need to find Z of X by using a series and parallel combination. So from right, shift it towards left, reduce the network. These two things are in series, add them. This two and parallel, simplify it. I'm not going in depth. What do you mean by series? What do you mean by parallel? Assuming that the basic you should know it. So Z of S, this two and parallel, simplify it. So multiply numerator and add them in denominator. Simplify the equation, that is R plus LS divided by CS, 4 upon, multiply over here, so it will be R into C into S plus C into L into S. It's only simplified more, take it down. So the equation for Z of S equal to R plus LS whole upon CS plus R C square S square plus C square L into S cube. So that's the value for Z of S. So that's a very simple sum when I said about driving point impedance. So let's have few more examples on driving point impedance, my dear friends. Thank you guys, signing off.